Hello there, this is Richard Digance, welcoming you to the yellowcafe.co.uk and to a daily collection of my thoughts of mindfulness in the advent of. At this time of loneliness, join me to chill as together we approach the season of goodwill. I'm here every day until Christmas. Come along on the journey. Well, in the advent of, the answer is really in the title. It's 24 days of Advent to take us right the way up to Christmas Eve. I've never really felt lonely, to be honest. Not until this year, and yet I've done so much stuff on my own. I suppose the thing that I harp back on is travelling through the night. For over half a century, that's what I've done. I've done shows as a musician, and I get in my car, and when the audience are back home, tucked up in their beds with their hot chocolate, and their loved ones, hopefully, I'm in my car, heading back home, usually down a drab, weary motorway, especially this time of the year in December. I think back to the glorious days, weather-wise of course, during lockdown, and we sat in the garden and we just thought, well, it's not great, but at least the sun is shining, it's something. This time of the year of course it's different. This is when loneliness starts hitting you. Well, I don't want it to hit you. I don't want it to hit me either. And so I'm going to tell you about a very special friend of mine. A friend that quelled my loneliness through those dark hours of driving home through the night after a show. Strangely, my friend was made of wood. It was my guitar. I've had my guitar for many, many years. And it is my friend upon the road. And there's times I've been sitting there, looking through the windscreen with the wipers going in the pouring rain, talking to myself, but not really, because on the back seat is my little mate. I travelled many a mile from Cornwall way up to Carlisle. I've seen all Britain can show me as its countryside passed way below me. Sometimes I just long to get home, spend a few hours on my own with you. Yes, with you. Because, my little wooden friend, you're the best friend I ever knew. With you. I travelled so far that I just couldn't stand. But you were there. You gave me a hand. We continued the long journey together. Two trusty companions, me and my wooden friend together. The sight most dear to my eyes is to be where my little home lies. It's to be there with you. Yes, with you. I just think of the things that we're going to do. With you. Yes, my friend, with you. You'll be in the case, you'll be tucked away, but you're still there by my side. It's a long, winding journey we chose. Where it will take us, God only knows. Wherever you are, don't forget me. Because my love for you won't ever let me. And you know, sometimes when my eyes are sore, you know that I wonder, what's it all for? So do you. Oh yes, so do you. But it's just something we both have to do. And it's true. Yes, it's true. I do it with you. Yes, I've travelled many a mile, down from Cornwall up to Carlisle. I have seen all Britain can show me, and its countryside passing below me. But sometimes I long to get home, just to spend a few hours on my own, but not really on my own, not lonely, because I'm with you. Yes, with you. You are and always will be the best friend that I ever knew. With you. Yes, I did travel till I couldn't stand. And yes, I'm very aware, when I was tired up there on the stage, you gave me a hand. And then it was back on the road, you and I together. Two trusty friends, clocking up those miles forever. And I still say the sight most dear to my eyes is to be where my little home lies, with you. Yes, with you. I just think of the things we've done and what we shall do. And I'll do them all one day. When all this is over, I'll be back on the stage with you. I hope that isn't corny, but it sums up how to get through strains of loneliness. Because I have spent endless, endless hours in my car, chugging home through all sorts of weather, especially this time of the year, as I say. And I do think, what's it all for? I'll tell you what it's all for. It's the life that I chose. And it's a sort of a life that it's difficult to make lots and lots of friends, to be brutally honest. Millions of acquaintances, yes. But because I spend so much time away from home, it's hard to nurture friendships. One thing I have is a trusty friend. You have a trusty friend too. Even in these lonely, dark times, there's someone. Of course there is. And you know what? For the last 10 minutes, I'd love to think that that trusty friend has been me. Because together, we've done what the NHS asked us to do, which is just chill out and share a moment or a few moments of mindfulness, in the hope that just things will get better. I'm sure they will. It's been a pleasure to be with you for the last 10 minutes. Look after yourselves, keep safe, and don't be lonely, because loneliness can be shared, and we just have. Take care. For someone special. Write a poem for someone special. I tell you what, I think that will make that Christmas for you, don't you? This is what loneliness is all about. Sharing it. How can you possibly share loneliness? I don't really know the answer to that. But do you know what? For the last 10 minutes, thanks to the NHS, it's exactly what we've done. See you tomorrow.